Okay, today we're going to try and attempt a fluid abstract painting. To begin, I'm just going to paint the canvas black. It's mostly going to be black with some, I think, metallic tones in there. And we'll see what happens. Alright, so we got the black base. We're going to mix up some probably dark colors with a couple of light just to mix in there to have some high contrast and see what happens. Okay, now that we got the base color down, we're going to have to mix our colors. Since we're doing a fluid painting, we're going to be using the Liquitex pouring medium. We're going to pour this into our little containers, whatever you have. A lot of people use solo cups. I just use these small, like, serving dishes or sauce cups. I don't know what they're called. So what we're going to be mixing today is a couple of metallics. We're going to use the Liquitex Basics acrylic paints, and it's going to be copper, gold, the Mars black, titanium white, and cobalt blue hue. So for my base colors, I think I'm going to use black to keep the black theme going, gold and copper, and pour those on here, move things around, see if we can get something cool looking for an abstract background, and then I think we're going to come in over the top with some white and maybe a streak of blue just for some high contrast. So what you want to do with this pouring medium, shake it up and then again I have a new bottle. I should probably check this stuff before I start filming, but I don't. Shake it up. I'm going to be using a lot of black, so use a bunch of medium. And then with the actual paint, you don't need that much, just a little squirt will do. Maybe a little bit more. And I'm just using cheap little plastic palette knives to mix this up. Mix it, but don't go too crazy hard and fast on this because you don't want any bubbles. I see a few starting to form. Just mix it nice and smooth until you don't see any bubbles in there. You have to work fast. It's acrylics, it's going to dry fast. Plus you want it as liquid or fluid as possible. So I'm going to mix these other two up real quick. There we go. Not too bad. Alright. I'm going to go back and mix up my first one real quick. Oh yes, and one other thing is when we're doing the fluid paintings, give yourself some space. It's really messy. I have the plastic tarp down and I also have a layer of paper towels underneath my canvas. And another thing you want to do is prop it up. I use my little serving cups for that. Because if you just leave it, especially on paper towel, even if you leave it on plastic, it's going to stick, and then your end result is just going to be a mess of paper towels or something's going to rip off of your canvas. So, here we go. There we go. Got a pretty interesting texture going on. I don't know, with the glare of the lights, it's probably a little too shiny, but there we go. It's not the real fluid idea that I was thinking of in the beginning, but I like where it's headed. I think I might mix up some more black. Kind of pour it on there and try and get this fluid feeling going. See what happens. So now we got kind of a marbled texture on top of the first texture, which is kind of cool. We got some of the copper coming out from the bottom. And then we got this blackish gold on top, which is kind of cool. All I'm doing is just lightly pulling it to the side, just kind of letting my knife kind of graze the top of the paint. That looks pretty cool. I think what I'm gonna do is wash off these knives because they're starting to get a little sticky. Let that sit for a second and then maybe come over the top with some white. And see what happens. It's only been a couple of minutes. I didn't cut away for too long, but as you can see, things are still kind of moving and separating. Hopefully you can see, again with that glare, some of this stuff is pretty cool. It's kind of a cool texture. And this is just like a background, so it's not, has to be anything amazing. What I'm going to do right now is take this white and see what happens. I just mixed it with some hot water, so we're going to see how that mixes with the fluid medium. Pouring medium, not fluid medium. Let's see if I can get something interesting going on here. It's always tricky trying to spread something where you want it. And if you, and you only get one shot, so if you mess it up, it's there forever. So, I also don't want to go way off my canvas and onto the carpet. So this is going to be tricky. Let's move this just in case. Or let's get this tarp. Alright. Floor. We'll see how it sits too, because this pouring medium is just going to keep spreading slowly, which will spread out the white on top. Actually, it says to let this sit and dry for 3 whole days. Slightly disappointing if you want to dive right back into it. This should be dry if you leave it overnight. But since it's so glossy and it's so heavy, you should let it sit for 2 or 3 days just to make sure everything sits into the canvas. And then you can return, you can paint on top of it, or you can start throwing some more stuff on top of it. It's not bad, I kind of like how that came out. I might also throw another streak of something on there. Maybe some red. Not a lot, just a little bit, just see maybe how that plays in with the white, and maybe come back on top with some white again. Alright, mixed up a couple more colors. A little bit dark red. Just red with a tiny bit of black mixed in. A little bit more black, a little bit more white. Just in case we feel like adding some more. And yeah, I definitely, when I threw that white on, hit my floors, missed my tarps, had to clean all that stuff up. That's why I usually have a setup which is a lot different than this, but we're trying a new technique, so canvas had to be flat, but usually I just have everything set up kind of in a semicircle so I can just throw things and not have to worry about missing a tarp. But anyways, figured this just needs a little bit more color. I don't know where. There's the tiny drip. And there. And there, apparently. couple right there. Let's see what this does. Not bad. That's not bad. I almost threw some right on my chest because I'm an idiot and I threw this way. Usually I should position myself around the canvas and throw it away from me so I don't get it all over myself. Luckily I didn't completely drench myself. So while this is still wet, kind of want to layer the white and the red. So the white was in the background, looks like red's on top. Just want to come back in with some white. Seems super liquidy. Maybe I'll mix this up a little bit. All right, all I did was just kind of mix it a little bit more. Just want to add a tiny bit. Put some right in the middle of that one. Maybe in the middle of this dot. Oops. A little further than I wanted. Yeah, not bad. So I got a little bit of a layer crisscrossing everywhere. I like seeing what these little dots do inside of each drop of paint. Put a little too much there. Wasn't excited about that. But I also mixed up some black, which looks not very liquidy, so maybe I'll add some more water. Okay, all I did was add a little bit more water, and it's definitely a lot more fluid, a lot more liquid. I don't think I really want to do much with this black. Maybe a couple dots or drips somewhere. That's about it. If I have anything left of this red, maybe I'll add a couple drops. Alright. If there is anything. I think that's good enough for now. Hopefully you could actually see what I was doing. It seems like there's a lot of glare since it's very glossy from this pouring medium. And actually, of this 8-ounce bottle, I probably used about half of it, or almost half of it, just on this. And as you can see, it was kind of fluid in the beginning, but I should have used a lot more paint and a lot more medium. I only had the small bottle, so I'll definitely be picking up a gallon bucket of it at some point, because it's really cool. It has fun textures to play with, and maybe bigger containers than these little sauce containers. Just so we can really throw some paint on, and then we can get some cool waves in here. But pretty happy with how it turned out. This is gonna sit for, like I said, 2 to 3 days. It's gonna be tough since it's right in the middle of my kitchen. I don't wanna move it. It is still very liquid, as you can see. If I even pick this up and try to move it and then I trip or jolt it, then everything's gonna move and it's just not gonna look the same. Not that everything's perfect here, but it's not too bad. Once this finally settles, like I said, it'll probably dry overnight so you can touch it and you can move it without the paint running. But you do want to let it sit for a couple of days. So yeah, there you go. Hopefully you like this little fluid technique, which isn't extremely fluid and wavy, but it's how I use it, and it's pretty fun. So I'll come back in a few days, get you an image of the final result, and it should be good. All right, so hopefully you like this. If you did, let me know. If you want to see more things like this, I'll keep doing this and variations of this and see what we can come up with. Thanks.